Vamos a pasar a una actualización de la compañía Car2Go, que estuvo por acá en Miami haciendo un anuncio sobre sus operaciones y la expansión aquí en Estados Unidos.
Hi, Margo, from Car2Go, from Austin, Texas. What are you doing here in Miami?
Today I'm here in Miami to announce we're having an anniversary party and open house event to celebrate Car2Go Miami's great numbers. We have 16,000 members and 240 vehicles around the city.
And 16,000 members in just 1 year. I mean, that's like more than 1,000 a month if you would the math that way, right?
Yeah, it's really taking off here and we're having great reception. I think people are really enjoying the fact that you can take the cars to the beach now. We have satellite locations and parking lots, and I've just been seeing them all around the town.
Yeah, me too. And actually, not only me, I have some visitors from Chile last month here in Miami. They noticed the cars on the street and they ask about it, and I explained the concept and they loved it. But they were asking if anybody comes from Miami from another country can like be part of the program.
Absolutely. All you would need to do is contact the city that you're going to be visiting, and or Car2Go, the city Car2Go office of each city that you're visiting, and they will ask you to provide a driving record, and they'll send you the card that can be used once you're visiting.
So for example, if someone comes from vacation here to Miami, they contact the office, they do the arrangement and all that. And where's the car? The car is going to be at some location they can pick it up?
Yes, the cars will be within a 25 square mile home area that we have here in Miami, and they can look on their app if they have a smartphone, download our free Car2Go app, and within that app it'll show you each vehicle, how much fuel it has, if it's clean inside and outside, and you can reserve it for a 3-minute window so you have time to get to it.
That's great. And besides Miami, you are in many other cities. I mean, the company started in Austin. Well, it started in Europe, in Germany, I believe, right, with the Daimler Group, and then expanded. And now in the U.S., North America, how many cities do you have?
We're in 10 cities in North America. We just opened this year in Denver about 2 months ago. And within, I guess, North America, we're in Austin, Denver, San Diego, Portland, Seattle, Vancouver, Toronto, Calgary, Washington, D.C., and Miami, so we're having a wonderful time.
That's great. And again, please, for the people who are not very familiar with the system, how does it work?
Okay, so it's a point-to-point car sharing. It's by the minute, so you swipe into a vehicle with a membership card that we issue to you. You have a 4-digit PIN code that you enter into the vehicle so that we can verify you are the correct driver. And then you're just charged by the minute. It's 38 cents a minute. You can take it anywhere, even outside of the 25 square mile home area. But to begin and the trip, you must be within that home area. And then, so if you drive for 5 minutes, you're charged for 5 minutes, and we've discounted hourly.
But there's an initial fee, a membership fee or something like that?
It's a one-time $35 fee, and that gets you the membership card and fuel, parking, maintenance, insurance are all included in that.
How does the fuel part work? Because if I'm, let's say we're here in Miami and I work, I drive to Boca Raton, which is 50 miles up and down. I mean, the Smart gives great mileage, but still, I mean, you're gonna use some gas, right? So how does that work? And you're responsible to fill it up again, or how?
Oh, no, you're not. So we have a fleet team in place in every city, and they monitor each car and how much fuel is in it. There is a fuel card in each car as well, so if you would like to fuel it up, there's some PIN numbers within the, I guess, navigation screen that you'd be able to use, but you're not required to do that. If you do fuel it up under a certain amount, you get some extra minutes as well as a kind of a courtesy thank you.
Very cool. And always a Smart car, right?
I mean, always a Smart car.
That's pretty cool. And always white and blue.
Always the white and blue. Those are our signature colors.
No, it's cool because I think people are starting to recognize them more. And like, for example, my friends from Chile were very excited. Like, they wanted to bring it back to Chile.
But they should.
I think you're in many countries too, right?
Yes. Yes, we're all over Europe right now. Yeah. We're in Germany and, we're in, I think, Birmingham and London. And
yeah, South America probably is a little bit behind that schedule, but I'm sure it's going to come there because it's a great concept.
Yes, we're always looking for different cities that would be a great fit for Car2Go. Right.
Well, thank you very much for your time and the information, and congratulations, and maybe next year you come and we will see, what, 32,000 maybe?
Yeah, the sky's the limit.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Esa fue Margaret Hake, portavoz de la compañía Car2Go, que como dijo ella, anunció aquí en Miami la expansión de sus operaciones. Ya tienen 16 mil miembros, tienen 10 ciudades en Norteamérica, y un concepto que realmente es muy interesante para todos los que no quieren comprar un auto, no quieren alquilar uno full time, y lo pueden tener así para su consideración. Así que Car2Go aquí en Miami, en 10 ciudades en Norteamérica, en Estados Unidos y en Canadá. Y no se vayan, que cuando regresemos aquí en Auto 060 vamos a hablar del debut de la nueva Toyota Tundra 2014, la pickup truck que está tratando de competir con los grandes de Detroit. Esto es Auto 060, yo soy Javier Mora.